Hi. In this video, we will learn about a data lake. What exactly is a data lake? Can we define it in simple terms without getting into the technical details? That's what I hope to do in this video. Okay, so let's look at a very simple definition of a data lake. A data lake is a large repository of all enterprise data. Right, so it is one place where all the enterprise data is available. The word lake refers to the capability of storing and manipulating very large volumes of data. Also, a data lake is designed to be a one-stop shop for all data needs of an organization and the departments within that organization. Before we get into a little bit details of a data lake, let's start with the problem definition, meaning what is the problem that we are trying to solve with the data lake as a solution? This is a simple diagram of data movement within an organization. Take any organization these days. There are a lot of internal systems and there are a lot of external systems from which the data needs to be consumed. In this example, we have the Salesforce, which is a cloud-based software service. We have a point of sale, which is on-premise. We have social media such as Facebook. We may have a relational database like MySQL and cloud storage. All of these are used in some form or the other to run the organization. Now, for other departments within the same organization, there may be a need to consume data from all of these organizations. One example is a data mart or a data warehouse. This is considered a downstream application because it does not generate data on its own. Instead, it fetches the data from all the other upstream systems, right? So as you can see, the data mart needs to interface with all these different systems, and often the interfaces are not the same. For example, the Salesforce may be using an API. The point of sale may be creating some kind of a data extract. Facebook again may be an API. The MySQL may be direct database calls and so on, right? So a downstream application like DataMart will need to interface with these multiple applications using different protocols such as HTTP, FTP, database calls, files, and so on. Just like DataMart, there can be another application, let's say a forecasting application, that also needs data from these systems. Now, as the organization grows, as the business grows, a lot of these downstream applications start sourcing the information from these upstream applications. Over time, we have the multiple downstream applications consuming data from the upstream applications. And as you can see, there are multiple calls being made to the upstream systems. And over time, a source like, let's say, Facebook can be called more than twice. In this is a very simple example. You know, I've just listed two downstream applications, but in reality, you could have a lot of applications over time, and the list keeps growing. Right, the list of applications like DataMart and forecasting that are dependent on data from these other systems. And the problem here is every time there is a new system, they have to go through this cycle of identifying the systems where the data is, establishing the connectivity using whatever protocol it is, and then getting the data. And when it's a database or an API, it's not straightforward. The availability of the system changes, right? The protocol itself could change, and the downstream system has to repeat all of this process, right? So although the data mart has been using these interfaces, forecasting still has to create its own pipelines. So likewise, any new downstream systems have to create their own connections, define their own connections to the upstream systems. So over time, it becomes very unmanageable. Now, the solution. Enter data lake. So as you can see, I have represented the data lake as the water body namesake, right, which is a lake. So the data lake is a platform. It is one repository where you have all the data. So what do we do here? What we do is, you can see all the upstream systems have a single line or a single connection established between the upstream and the data lake. And all the data is either pushed or pulled to the data lake, right? So the data lake acts as a central repository where all of the data is available. Now look at the downstream systems such as data mart, forecasting, and power users. They no longer have to directly connect to the upstream. Instead, they connect to data lake. And the advantage is, when they connect to the data lake, they don't have to deal with these individual interfaces. They don't have to learn where the data is, right? They just know that the data lake is the central repository. Every data that an organization needs is already present in the data lake. Okay, so the downstream systems no longer have to, they no longer have to handle all the complexity that is involved in these different interfaces. Instead, they can use a single interface and connect to the data lake and have access to all the data they need. And once you set up a data lake, it really becomes easier to enable a lot of other downstream applications, right? And then you have power users as well. Power users are special individuals whose main responsibility is to use data to derive insights. Such individuals have a lot of need for data across systems, right? So now we enable these special individuals as well. They now have a central repository to which they can go and, you know, have access to all the data they need to do their analysis. Okay, so that's one. Now you may ask yourself this question, like, you know, isn't this like common sense? Why wasn't this done before? Why wasn't data lake a reality before? Why did we do it now? Why are organizations doing it now? Well, the answer is this. Everybody tried to create a data lake of their own, right? And as you can see, data lake is something that spans across systems. It has a lot of data and it keeps growing, right? Now, a decade ago, organizations tried to build a data lake, and the only solution available at that point in time was relational databases or file systems. File systems were very difficult to manage, so they went with databases. Databases, yes, we were able to scale. However, they were very expensive to develop and maintain because all of the relational databases had a licensing cost. You know, if you want to scale, you have to purchase a new license. Even if you were to add more CPUs, CPU cores within the existing server, you again had to purchase licenses, right? So it was prohibitive to be able to run a data lake operation back then. Now, thanks to this whole big data platform, right? And the most popular being Hadoop at the moment, right? So the big data platform was built for such use cases. A big data platform is something that is easily scalable, has a large ecosystem where you can have additional software added to it, and then it has low running cost as well. All of these factors combined, now is the perfect time to create data lakes. So you see many organizations, no matter what the scale, even from startups to large organizations, are creating their own data lakes, and almost all of them are based on Hadoop. So data lake is not a new concept. People knew that this had to be built. However, the cost is something that prevented them from doing so. Now we have the technology, be run with very low running cost, and we don't have just one software. Instead, we have an ecosystem. Hadoop is the perfect example for it. You have a lot of other software that sit on top of Hadoop, that work on top of Hadoop. Well, I won't be getting into details of it. Now, coming back, now that we have the technology and the software, data lake has become a reality. Now, to quickly summarize the benefits of a data lake, it's a one-stop shop for all enterprise data. We can reuse existing data pipelines instead of defining a pipeline every time we want data from an upstream system. And we enable power users to do cross-department data access, meaning they have access across multiple departments or multiple subject areas. Now, there is, often people confuse the data lake with the word big data or data lake with data warehouse. In many organizations, they say that, okay, we now have a data lake. We have, got rid of our data warehouse and such statements. So let's look at what exactly is it. How is data lake related to big data or data warehouse? First, we'll look at, is data lake the same as big data, right? Well, they are somewhat related, but they're not exactly the same. All right. So data lake is a use case. You see, big data is a platform. Hadoop is a platform. Hadoop can be used for many different things. Data lake is one solution that can be built on Hadoop. Data warehouse is one solution that can be built on Hadoop. Even data archival is something that can be built on top of Hadoop. So Hadoop being a big data platform, it is a platform, right? It provides capabilities. How you use it is up to you. So in that sense, data lake is a solution that can be built using a big data platform like Hadoop. And, especially Hadoop, as you know, it has greatly reduced the running cost of a data lake. Hence, the big data platform is where you build your data lake. Next question is data lake the same as data warehouse? Well, many people are saying yes, data lake is the same as data warehouse. Again, no, this would be very incorrect statement. If you look at the pure definition of a data warehouse, what is a data warehouse? A data warehouse is a separate database that is maintained exclusively for measuring the business performance. We apply all the concepts of dimensional modeling. In other words, Kimball methodology. We follow Rolf Kimball methodology. We follow dimensional modeling and we arrive at dimensions and facts and aggregations and other derived tables and columns, right? So a data warehouse is very specific to measuring business performance. However, data lake, again, is more of a storage solution. Right? We are storing data that's coming from the upstream. Now, when we store this data, we may or may not do any transformations. In other words, we store the data as is. So let me quickly go back to the earlier slide. When we fetch the data from Salesforce or point of sale or Facebook, the data will be stored in its raw format, meaning we are not deriving any columns, we are not manipulating or changing the data whatsoever. We store the data as is in its original format, right? So that the downstream systems will decide what to do with the data, right? So we let the downstream decide what to do with the data. We don't make any changes. However, in the case of a data warehouse, we explicitly manipulate the data. And if you have a little bit of background on dimensional modeling, you would know what I'm referring to. We create dimensions. We denormalize data. In some cases, we normalize data. We create facts and so on. So all that being said, data lake does not equal data warehouse. However, data lake being a platform that is capable of hosting large amounts of data becomes a perfect platform in which you can store a data warehouse as well. So what would likely happen is in organizations, you have a data lake, you reserve a small part of it for your data warehouse as well. So you start storing your dimensions and facts in the data lake as well. Okay, so that's how data lake and data warehouse are related. However, they're not the same. Okay, so just a quick summary. Data lake, it's a very large database or a data store to store all enterprise data, right? It's usually built on a very highly scalable platform like Hadoop. It has a low running cost compared to relational databases or MPP databases like, let's say, Teradata, right? All data accessible in a single repository or environment. This is the big win of a data lake. All right, so that's all I had to discuss about the data lake. I hope you found this useful. If you do, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.